Hello children, good morning. I know you all are waiting for my module. Today I am going to tell you about your Percy Jackson's The Lightning Thief. Rick Riordan, in full Richard Russell Riordan, an American author and teacher who was perhaps best known for his hugely popular Percy Jackson and the Olympians book series, which blends Greek mythology with modern day characters and settings. He began writing for young adults after his son asked him to tell bedtime stories involving Greek gods. Once he related all the myths he knew, Riordan began making up stories and the idea for Percy Jackson was created. Percy Jackson is a 12-year-old New Yorker who has dyslexia and, for reasons unknown, he often finds himself in unique situations that get him kicked out of school. During a school trip to a museum, a bully, Nancy Beaufort, bullies Percy's friend Grover. At the same time, Percy defends his friend, the fountain that they were next to grabs Nancy. However, Nancy believed that she was pushed into the fountain and lies about the incident to Mrs. Dodds, Percy's pre-algebra teacher. Mrs. Dodds separates Percy from the rest of the class before she transforms into one of the furies from Greek mythology and attacks him. Mr. Bronner, Percy's Latin teacher, tosses a pen to Percy and when uncapped, it transforms into a sword. Percy kills Mrs. Dodds and when he returns to the class, no one seems to remember the pre-algebra teacher. Only Grover seems suspicious when Percy confronts him. Percy seeks Mr. Bruner for extra help on Latin for the final the following week. However, he unwittingly hears Grover and Mr. Bruner talking about him and about a stolen item that was important. Percy goes home on the last day of school and his mother Sally takes him to the beach house where Percy's parents met long ago. Unfortunately, that night a storm rages and Grover wants them to flee. They are attacked by the miniature while driving to the countryside. And the ensuing fight, Sally disappears in a gold flash when the monster grabs her. Enraged Percy kills the miniature and passes out soon afterwards. 3 days later, he walks up in the infirmary of camp, Half-Blood, where Grover and Mr. Bruner, who is Chiron, the camp director, tell him that he is a demigod, half mortal, half god. But his godly parent is unknown. For this reason, he is sent to the Hermes cabin, which receives all the unclaimed demigods. During his time there, he befriends Luke, the cabin leader, and sons of Hermes, becomes an acquaintance of Annabeth, a daughter of Athena, and an enemy of Clarice, who is a daughter of Ares. Through a series of events during Percy's stay at camp, Poseidon claims him. However, just as the trident that claimed him fades away, a helihound bursts into camp and sends the campers into panic. As these monsters supposedly are unable to enter to protect the camp, Chiron sends Percy on a quest. Percy is eventually tasked by the Oracle to retrieve Zeus' stolen lightning bolt, mistakenly believed to have been taken by Poseidon. Poseidon, however, blames Hades for stealing it, in hopes of starting a war. Annabeth and Grover go west with him in order to retrieve the stolen items. However, upon reaching the Hades' lair, Hades accuses Percy of stealing his helm, threatening to kill him and his mother before releasing the dead into the world. Percy and his friends escape and they find out that Ares had stolen items all along. Percy fights the god of war in a duel and surprisingly wins. Percy returns the helm to Hades and in return Hades returns Sally safely. After Percy returns the lightning bolt to Zeus, Luke reveals that he was a thief and is working for Neronus, the lord of the Titans. He tries to kill Percy by calling on a pit scorpion but Percy survives. At the end of summer, Percy ultimately chooses to return home for the school year before he comes back for the next summer. Thank you, children. I hope you all enjoyed. See you in the next module.